This is a video response to Tanya TKO's video titled Black Woman's Burden. I'd actually made one already, but I took it down because I felt as though there were things I could have hit on, but didn't. In Tanya's video, Black Woman's Burden, she asked the question whether or not we think there are people with superior and inferior complexes. Yes, there are. There are different levels of these complexes. People may or may not realize that they even have them, because the majority of the time these superior or inferior complexes are on a subconscious or subliminal level. There are different kinds of superior and inferior complexes as well, meaning it's not restricted to somebody's color making them feel superior or inferior. People are more likely to know they have a superior complex as opposed to an inferior one. Nearly all people that have some form of inferior complex don't know, because it's on the subconscious level. Both superior and inferior complexes are and can be detrimental to others. A person with a superior complex doesn't really inflict damage on themselves as opposed to what they inflict on other people. A person with an inferior complex inflicts damage not only on themselves, but also others. A good example of an inferior complex is this. Now, my son is biracial, meaning his father is black, but obviously I'm not. My son does know that he is black, like his father, just light-skinned. I, on several occasions, have had people I know and strangers walk up to me and my son and say that he has good hair. Now, this is meant as a compliment, alright? But it's as if to imply that if he had an afro or if his hair were kinkier, it wouldn't be good. On top of which, as if saying that weren't bad enough, even though they got good intentions because they're meaning it as a compliment, they sincerely mean no harm saying this. I've seen people walk past other kids with beautiful hair, beautiful kinky hair and afros. The hair, you know, the cut is low, their shit is lined up right, and they say this in front of them. If things like this happen enough, after a while, automatically, that child's brain is going to start working on a subconscious level and start associating good hair with, you know, more straight and less kinky. And hair that's no good, kinky like theirs. Do y'all see where I'm going at with this? I mean, this is just one example I'm using, and this is just the tip of the iceberg. This is an example of an inferior complex on a subconscious level, because this person is not meaning to insult or demean anybody. They're actually, that's what they've been programmed to believe. And the majority of the time, when biracial children don't have kinky hair, they're light skinned. So you got, you know, you're saying this child has good hair, on top of the fact they're light skinned. The mind is a very strong and a very powerful thing, and it processes information and things in ways that we can't even imagine, let alone children who are very receptive. Is that the word I'm looking for? They're very receptive to things because they're children. They haven't learned everything. They haven't been programmed like we have as adults. But it can escalate. But do y'all see what I'm talking about as an inferior complex? These are things that we have to stop doing. I mean, catch yourself if you see you doing it. Think about, you know, like, damn, that shit. You know, that's what it really is. Because if you look at it, a person, whatever person, what kind of person hair is, ain't nobody got hair any better than the next damn person. My son doesn't have better hair than anybody of these other damn kids. So we gotta think about things that we do and how it affects other people on a subconscious level. We have to be aware of these things, because if we're not aware, we're never gonna be able to stop the